We're standing on holy ground tonight. Everywhere your foot trods in this place, you're in the presence of a king. Let's act like it. Jesus is in the house tonight. Jesus is in the house tonight. This ain't about us. This ain't about man. This ain't about nothing but God tonight. Let's get our minds totally focused on him. Let's get our minds on Jesus tonight. Jesus is moving by his Spirit. Jesus is moving tonight by his precious Holy Ghost tonight. His Holy Spirit is precious tonight. Let's not take it lightly. If you got to talk to somebody, go outside and talk to somebody. If you got to leave and do something, go outside. This time is set apart for God. He's going to move mightily. He's going to have his way tonight. And I just thank him for what he's doing. I can't thank him enough. I'm humbled by his presence in here. I'm humbled by his touch. I'm humbled by what God's doing in this place. He's stirring his people, church. If you want to know what's going on, read the book of Acts chapter 2. The Bible says, in the last days, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Young and old shall have dreams and visions. And on your handmaidens and on your servants I shall pour out my Spirit. We're witnessing that tonight. Amen. Book of Acts is coming alive right before our very own eyes. And we're going to enter into worship here with Benny. And he's going to take us into the presence of God tonight. Let's just come tonight, amen, with our hearts fixed on Jesus. Let's just settle that right now. What are you here for tonight? Are you here for Jesus tonight? Are you here for him tonight? Are you here for Jesus tonight? You know, before we get started with the worship and praise, I wanted to share a word. Uncle Billy prophesied over me about 2.5 years ago, maybe 3, right here on a Sunday morning. He prophesied over me. I told Hazel about it, told Uncle Ham, Aunt Debbie about it. He said, Daniel, he said there's a revival coming. He said, it's not just going to be for the youth. He said, but it's going to be for the young and old. And he said, for the hard hearts. Listen, God's going to take some people who you never thought would be touched, and he's going to bring them to their knees tonight. Listen, the Bible says every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We're going to do it someday. We're going to bow before him someday. Amen. God's going to take the hardened hearts. God's going to take them hardened hearts, and he's going to plow. He's going to plow tonight. He's going to plow. If you know someone that ain't here tonight, call out their name to God tonight. That's what this is truly about, is there's people bound by drugs tonight. There's people bound. Listen, they can't, when you're bound, you can't help yourself. You know, there's people out, they don't want to be in the bars. They don't want to be doing the wrong things that they're doing. They want to be where you're at tonight in the presence of the king. But there's an adversary, the devil's as a roaring lion tonight, seeking who he may devour. And tonight, by the power of God, we're going to believe for our lost loved ones. We're going to believe for the young and the old and the hard hearts. We're going to believe that God's going to break down every chain. He's going to break down every wall. He's going to break down, amen. He's going to plow up the fallow ground. Some people's hearts have been so tough, you'd say you never can get through. I've come to tell you, one touch from Jesus Christ could take the worst sinner in this world and turn them into a Christian tonight. Turn them into a preacher tonight. Turn them into a worshiper tonight. Come on, we've been seeing people worshiping God who's never worshiped God before like this. We're seeing people praise God who's never praised God like this. You say, what is this? What is going on here? Listen, Jesus is worthy of all praise and all glory and all honor. You know, the Bible says clap your hands. The Bible says to raise your hands. You know, the Bible says to shout with the voice of triumph. And you know what? When we begin to praise tonight, I want you to praise like you mean it. I want you to shout like you mean it. Because when we begin to praise an almighty God, God begins to come down and inhabit the praises of his people. And all them things that had you bound tonight, because of his goodness tonight, in his grace, he's going to set you free tonight. He's going to set you free. We're going to say a prayer. Let's all pray, and I'm going to have Benny come and lead us in worship. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, God, in Jesus' name, God, Lord, we come before you, God, Lord, with broken hearts tonight. We come before you, God, Lord. We're not worthy, Father God. Jesus, help me,
God.
We're not worthy, God, but Lord, by your grace, God, by your blood tonight, God, Lord, you made us more than conquerors tonight, Jesus. We can stand boldly in your presence tonight, Jesus. God, Lord, and we give everything over to you tonight, God, Lord. God, Lord, set us aside, God, Lord, I pray tonight, Jesus. Set us aside tonight, Jesus. And we, God, we declare that we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise, God, in everything that's done in this service. Be it all to you, God, in Jesus' name.
Let's just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost and lift our voices up right now.
the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and say, you are worthy of it all. Oh,
above all the earth, and thou art exalted,
with every hand lifted in this house, looking to Jesus, looking to Jesus.
We lift you high.
because you've got the sweetest name. I will
tell, I'll tell it, no matter where I go, I'll glorify, I'll glorify your name. I'll glorify, we glorify, we glorify. You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. Far from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Sing it out, sing, you're worthy of it all. Lift your hands to Him. You are worthy of it all. Far from you are all things, and to you are all things, and you deserve the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord. Oh, Jesus.
love you, Lord. Yes, I love you, Lord. With all my heart. With all my heart. And I love you, Lord. Yes, I love you, Lord. With all my heart. With all my heart. And I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. With all my heart. With all my heart. Yes, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. With all my heart. With all my heart. Oh! And I love you, Lord. Love you, Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and let all that's within shine. Get out the way, I get out the way, I get out the way. Oh, our flesh gets out the way, flesh gets out the way, flesh gets out the way. Bless the Lord. The Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Mighty is the Lamb, mighty is the Lamb, mighty is the Lamb. Oh, mighty is the Lamb,
oh, mighty is the Lamb,
mighty.
Faithful is the Lamb. He's faithful. Oh, faithful is the Lamb. Oh, faithful is the Lamb. Faithful is the Lamb. You are faithful. Faithful is the Lamb. Faithful is the Lamb. Just have your way, have your way. Lift your hands and sing, have your way. Have your way in me. Just have your way. Lord, have your way. Have your way. You're welcome in the sanctuary. Have your way, have your way, have your way. You are welcome in this place, you are welcome in this place. You are welcome in this place, you are welcome in this place. 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 You are welcome in our lives, Lord. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome, Lord. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome in my life. You are welcome here. You are welcome
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord, Father God. Jesus, Jesus. You know, this spirit that God's pouring out upon us, I feel led to tell you, it's not in a certain song. It's if the music stops and we sit back in our seats, the presence of God is still here. If we change the order of the service, God is still here. We can't stop God. Can you say amen? When the preacher comes to bring the word, God is here. How many knows it's important for the preaching of the word? And I want you to realize this is not a fad. This is not something that's just happening because we're making it happen. We can't make this happen. We can't force this. When we walked through these doors, when there wasn't a soul here and there wasn't a song being played, God was in this place. The presence of God was here. So I want you to realize that. It's nothing that's conjured up. It's the Spirit of God's here. What you're feeling is the Spirit of God. And if you don't feel it, I'm praying for you tonight that you would feel the power of God that is in this place. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Just lift your hands in this place. Let's pray for our loved ones right now. I feel led for us to pray for our loved ones. Those ones right now that are even in this place that are feeling the tug on their heart and they're just saying, you know, it ain't for me. Like Frank was saying last night, those ones that are afraid of the fire, they're afraid of the fire because when that fire, when they jump into it, they know it, they're going to be changed. They know there's going to be something different in them. Come on, begin to intercede. All saints of God right now, open your mouths and begin to pray for them. You are worthy, Jesus. Lord God, that one, Father God, my loved ones, Father God. My family, Father God. Lord God, that one closest to hell. Save their soul tonight, Jesus. Set them free from addiction tonight, Jesus. Lord God, you're God. You can do anything. Do it now, Father God. Oh, you're worthy, Jesus. You're worthy, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Holy, holy God.
Put your hands and sing.
Hallelujah. Holy, holy God Almighty.
mountains shake before you, the demons run and flee.
At the mention of the name, King of Man,
lift him up, there is, cause there is no power in
hell or any who could stand
before the power and the presence of the great I am.
The great I am. The great I am.
Oh,
he's the great I am. The great I am. The great I am.
Hallelujah.
And hallelujah, holy, holy,
you're God Almighty, you're the great I am, and who is worthy, there's none beside me, you're God Almighty.
I feel led to sing this over our families right now. Let's sing "The Mountain Trembles, Demons Run and Flee." There's no power in hell that can come against our family. No power in hell. With everything that you've got, with everything that you've got to the Lord, the mountains.
The mountains shake before you, the demons run. For the power and the presence of the great I am.
The great I am. He's the great I am.
The great I am, the great I am. Lift him up. He's the great I am. The same one that spoke to Moses. The same God that spoke to Moses is here. He's the great I am.
God, we bless you tonight. We bless you for your holy presence. There is none like you. God, I bless you tonight for touching this generation. That you said you'll pour out your spirit on all flesh. Lord, our generation today needs to know you personally. Lord, there is nothing like your presence, what they sense and what they feel. God, that it be an everlasting change and transformation in their lives. Not just a fad, something that's just happening, but God, that 40, 50 years from now, they'll be testifying what God done in 2014. We believe it for it. Hallelujah. 2014, it shall never be removed. America, 9/11, 01, what a date that they want to impact in our mind, but how much greater is this? 2014. I tell my children and my grandchildren, tell my great-grandchildren, I remember back 2014. Hallelujah. You see, some of you hear from your parents and your grandparents how God moved in them in the 70s and the 60s. And a few years from now, you'll be telling your children, 2014, God opened up heaven. That's what it's about. Hallelujah. Not just a coming and a going thing, but forever branded in our hearts and our lives. Let's lift up our hands and bless him one more time. God, we glorify you. We magnify you, oh God. There is none like you. In your presence is fullness of joy. You're a mighty God. Lord, we don't have the vocabulary to express our appreciation for your presence. We just praise you and thank you tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I felt like the Lord give me a word to minister, and I didn't know anything that was happening here. And when I got out of the car and walked towards the door, and I saw that sign that said can't be hid, I knew, Brother Daniel, that the Lord had dealt with my spirit. Can't be hid. You probably done heard sermons on that, but I'm gonna just elaborate on that just a few minutes. Hallelujah to God. You can be seated if you'd like, or you can stay at the altar. Don't matter to me. Hallelujah. You can just sit there and pray. And Jesus gave us a promise that if you're hungry and you're thirsty, I'll fill you. It's all he's looking for is somebody that's hungry. If you're hungry and thirsty, he'll fill you. Man, this is awesome. Hallelujah to God. Let me read one verse of scripture to you. Just one verse of scripture. In Judges chapter 13, in the last verse says, the Spirit of the Lord began to move him at times. Spirit of the Lord began to move Samson at times. A few weeks ago, I dreamed a dream. Don't ever dream, hardly ever. And in this dream, I saw a lot of lizards. And they were just changing colors. And I woke up, Brother Ham, woke me from this dream, screaming these words. You can't see them until they move. You can't see them until they move. And the Lord began to deal with me, not just on the lizards. I don't think that has any real spiritual significance, but you can't see them until they move. And I found in this verse of scripture I read to you, the Lord began to move on him at times. And as I studied, I found that the English word move is in the Bible a lot of times in a lot of places. But there are various Hebrew words, and it was translated into English move, but only one time in this verse right here was the Hebrew verb that actually means to get up and do something. Change the whole meaning of it, not just moving from here to there, but be propelled into action. Be driven into action. And so Samson, grew up among the Philistines. He dated the Philistine girls. He hung out with the Philistines, but there was something unique about him. He was dedicated to God from a baby. He had a vow placed upon his life from a child. He was reared, can we say, in the sanctuary. He was brought to the house of God, and he was just among the people, and he just lived among the people, and he just carried on his everyday life. But one day, I want you to get that in your spirit, one day the Spirit began to impel him. The Spirit began to drive him into action. Here we go back to the lizard now. This is where the lizard come in. You see, the lizard can change his colors, but he changes his colors to protect him from the predator. He don't change colors just to have something to do. He changes colors so he can blend into the environment so nobody sees him and nobody even knows he's there. And can I say it like this? We're not afraid of God. We love God. We honor God. We worship God. We go to church. We pay our tithes. We talk about God. We bless our food in the name of the Lord. And so it's not about not loving God. But you see, there's a predator out there in that world. And when we leave the sanctuary and we leave the place of safety, when we get in that world out there, and then when the predator shows up, when the predator begins to pounce upon us, Brother Bill, we change colors. We become like that lizard. We love God and we don't want to deny God, but we want to blend in so the predator can't see us. Can I tell you tonight, there's a predator on the loose and he is after you. But oh, hallelujah. I didn't even know what this theme was. But when I took a look at that door, said, I can't be hid. Can I tell somebody tonight, you need to quit changing colors. You need to stop blending in. And you need to let yourself be known and be revealed. If the world can come out of the closet, it's time the church come out of the closet and let the world know that we're not ashamed to be the blood bought, the redeemed of the Lord, the Holy Ghost filled. It ain't just something I do in the sanctuary. It can't be hid. Hallelujah. Samson grew up among the Philistines and he was just a part of their life. They had oppressed Israel for 40 years. He was just in their environment. But one day God said, they're not your friend, they're your enemy. One day the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. And one day he realized, this world is my enemy. And the Bible said he took the jawbone of a dead donkey's head and killed 1,000 Philistines with it. It's time the church get the Spirit to move on them and stand up and declare to them. They want to tell you, you can't do this and you can't do that and you can't preach and you can't sing and you can't testify. It's getting so political you can't even breathe the name of Jesus. But I want to say to you tonight, we cannot be hid. Jesus said, I will build me a church and the gates of hell shall never bring that church down. It's persecuted. Can I tell you tonight, I heard Brother Bill praying and I've been praying. There's people in Iraq that they are losing their lives. The women are being raped. Their children are being killed. They're driven into the mountains. They don't have any food. They don't have any water. They don't know how they're going to survive. They've lost everything they ever worked for. But you know what the problem is? They refuse to give up the name Jesus. They refuse to give up the name Jesus. They refuse. They're still a people. This ain't an Americanized gospel. It ain't a Western culture gospel. It's a world gospel. If I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. He's got a church that refuses to be hid, that's not going to blend in. It's going to tell the predator, bring all you got to bring. But I'm going to testify, and I'm going to praise, and I'm going to magnify God. I will not change my color. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I didn't know lizards could give me so much changing colors. You don't need to be blending in. You can't see him till he moves. We're like, we're all full of God, but when the predator comes, we're like, we love God, but we don't want the predator to see us. Amen. Jesus said, you're the light of the world, not the light of the church. Hallelujah. Can't be hid. Can't change colors. I gotta be what I am. Noah. He grew up in his generation. The Bible said in Genesis 6, men's minds were on evil continually. And you ain't got to look for sin. It's everywhere you go. Brother Bill, it's everywhere. Amen. There's sin. Gross darkness covers the earth. Corruption is, I was watching the news last night and I never seen so much shooting and killing going on. Police are so busy, they're so busy, they're just running from here to there to here to there. Kids just playing ball on a parking lot, somebody coming and shooting them for no reason. Noah grew up in his generation. Evil's everywhere. Evil is everywhere. Amen. And he wasn't even noticed hardly. Nobody even pay him much attention. But the Bible said in the book of Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6, but Noah by faith was moved. Noah was moved. You know what God's doing? He's stirring your nest to move you. He's stirring your nest to move you. He's stirring your nest to move you. We just blend into society. Nobody knows really who we are. But one day while you're grocery shopping, the Spirit's gonna move you. One day while you're at the post office, the Spirit's gonna move you. This thing ain't locked up in the four walls of Cornerstone Church building. Hallelujah to God. This ain't gonna be loosed on the way. It's gonna be, as Brother Jimmy said, you don't have to have a song to get this. When God gets ready to move you, you ain't gotta have a song. It don't take very much to get you started. By faith, Noah was moved. He woke up one morning and said, Sister Noah, you ain't gonna believe this, but I'm fixing to build a boat. She said, what's a boat? I got moved last night. It's going to rain. They ain't never seen no rain. The world ain't never seen something. You got to give them, and they ain't going to know about it till you get moved to explain it to them, to talk to them, to tell them about it. Hallelujah to God. We got to be moved and stop changing colors. Just woke up one day. Got moved overnight. A few months ago, four, five, 6 weeks, 7 weeks ago, I was up at Brother Ernie's at the men's conference. I flew up from Dallas to Baltimore. When I got on the plane, see, it don't happen all the time. You got to be sensitive to the Spirit. If you walk around with a big holy Bible under your arm, everybody you see, and you're like, are you saved? You born again? If you die right now, you're going to heaven or hell? What's your name? They're going to just look at you and walk off. They don't want to hear that. But if you're moved, I got on this airplane. I sat down by the window. This young lady sat down by me. I said, hello, how are you? She said, fine, how are you? I said, fine. For the next 2.5 hours, that's all we said. Never said another word. Never said a word, never said good to see you, happy to meet you, never said nothing. That was it. But when I left to go back home, I got on that plane, sat by the window. Here come a young lady, sit down beside me. I said, hello, how are you? She said, fine, how are you? She said, oh, I'm a nervous wreck. And the Lord will open a door. You got to be sensitive when to move. And I really want to take a nap because it's real early and I had to catch that early morning flight. And I really want a pillow to lay my head against the window. And I can sleep anywhere. I don't even need the pillow. Just snore. But all of a sudden, amen, I started this conversation with her. She's about 30 years old, about Kayla's age. And this young girl, she's going to see her grandparents in McAllen, Texas, and ain't seen them in years. And she lives in Lancaster. And she moved up here, and her life was a mess. And her dad was an alcoholic, and her mama's messed up on drugs, and her life is a mess. And she don't know what she's going to do. My life is a mess. And all of a sudden, I was moved, driven to action. 2 days before that, I rode that plane 3 hours and never said a word. But here I am right now, moved and driven to action. She said, what do you do? I said, I'm a preacher. Let me tell you about that. She said, tell me about the Bible. What is the Bible? 30 years old, I ain't never read the Bible in my life. I've never picked up the Bible. You ain't got to go to Africa to find people that don't know God. They live right next door to you. Amen. They ride around in vehicles all over the place. This country's full of people ain't got a clue about God. Ain't never set foot. There's teenagers, they never set foot in a church house. They don't know they can feel the power of God and they can walk in the glory of God. They
ain't got a clue unless you that have it gets moved and stop changing colors. The Bible said freely you have received. God don't give us an outpouring to shut it up in us. He gives us an outpouring to flow through us. Out of your belly flow a river. Let it flow, let it flow, let it flow. Flow a river of a living water. Oh, hallelujah. A young lady said to me, does the Bible have two parts? I heard the Bible has two parts. I said, yes, they're called the Old and the New Testament. Hallelujah to God. I never felt so preachy in my life. And for the next 2.5 hours, Sister Debbie, I was moved. 2 days ago, I just changed colors and set up out the window. Don't bother me. Don't talk to me. Don't see me. Just blend into the window. Y'all ain't shouting now. Just blend into the window. Leave me alone. But now I've been impelled. I've been driven to action. Hallelujah. The Bible said one plant, you may not see any results, but one plant, one waters, and God gives the increase. For 2 hours. 2 hours, Sister McKenzie, I talked to a young girl and never even read a Bible. Right here in America. Right here from PA in Texas. Tears started rolling down her face. My life's been a mess. What can I do about it? Whew. That's like pouring gasoline on a fire. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm trying to be real careful because I am a married man. This young girl's 30 years old. I got a child at her age. I took her by the hand in that seat, Brother Bill, and I started praying. I don't know the results of that prayer, but I know I was impelled. Noah woke up and said, baby, I'm fixing to build a boat. Samson got up one day and said, these Philistines aren't my friends, and I'm fixing to kill some of them. Hallelujah! The Bible said, let me go there for a minute. Colossians, I read today. I didn't even have this in my mind, but Paul said in Colossians, you need to mortify the deeds of your body. That means you need to kill some of them enemies you think is your friend. Some of them enemies you think is your friend. You need to draw out the sword of the Spirit and cut that fella off. Hallelujah. Let Zorro know he ain't got nothing on you. I read this morning. A man named Nehemiah in the 20th year. Can't even say that fellow's name, but he was king in the 20th year. Artaxerxes or something like that there. Thank God for Leon and Bill and Ham and names like that we can say real good. In the 20th year, he'd been his cupbearer for 20 years. He'd been bringing and serving the king every day, always doing his job, always come with a happy smile on his face, always just blending in. Nobody really knows anything about him. Knows, yeah, he's got kin folks. They went back home. Yeah, we know a little bit about his history. But one day, he showed up on his job. And that day, the king said, what's wrong with you? He said, you don't understand. I've been driven to action. My people's in trouble. My folks is in trouble. My church is in trouble. My city's in trouble. And I got woke up this morning with a burning. I've been impelled. I've been moved. I've been driven to action. I'm not changing colors no more. I'm moving. If you'll give me permission, I'm going to build a wall. And them people may be lazy. They won't pray. They won't fast. They won't seek God. They won't pay the tithes. But when I get moved and I get stirred, all God needs is somebody to get moved and somebody to get stirred up. Hallelujah. You won't. God. You want something supernatural to happen in that world? You ain't got to be pushy and shovey, but you just got to say, God, move me and put me. And if you set me and you move my spirit, I can make a difference. The Bible said Nehemiah walked among them and nobody was doing anything, but he began to pray and he just began to talk. In a few days, they all had a mind to work. And 52 days later, less than 2 months, they had a wall built with all hell against them. But he said, I ain't coming down. I ain't coming down. I'm working for God. Hallelujah. I just want to tell somebody tonight, you can't be hid. You got to quit changing colors. You gotta quit just blending into the scenery. Where's he at? He's just blending in. You gotta quit just looking like the building. Hallelujah. What you got in you, the world don't have. What you got in you, the world don't have. What you got in you. We was talking today with Pastor Ham. We was talking about in the early 70s when we got it, and all you young people don't want to hear it. But the fact is, we got it, and 40 years later, we still got it. Brother Eddie, I'm like that iguana now. I'm moving fast, but I'm moving. Hallelujah, ain't moving real fast. And the older you get, the slower you go. Hallelujah, but we're on the move, Brother Peel. Hallelujah. Say, we're on the move. Hallelujah, and that's why you're getting what you're getting. Because we've kept moving. We've kept praying. We ain't always seen it. It ain't happening every week. But when it does happen, know that God Almighty, God Almighty. Woo! Hallelujah. Would you stand? I'm through. I'm quitting. They're going to sing, worship some more. If you want to come back down here, I don't matter to me. I don't know what we're going to do. Hallelujah. But I just had to tell you, you can't. You maybe won't tell God, I don't want to change colors. When I get out there, I want to be what I am in here. Let me share this with you. A few months ago, I went to this little Pentecostal church. They had a Baptist preacher there for a special guest. Traditional Southern Baptist. Drier than corn shocks. Last year's corn shocks. But he got up there and he said, I pastored a little Baptist church down the road. He said, but I've been hungry for God. He said, I drive a log truck. I've been telling God I'm hungry and I want something. Don't really know what I want. I know I got a lot of Pentecostal preacher friends, but I ain't sure if that tongue thing is for me. But God, I'm hungry. He said something. Brother Ham came in the cab of that log truck. I was on one of them back lane, two lane roads of Louisiana. And he said it overwhelmed me. I started crying. I couldn't control myself. I pulled that log truck over to the side of the road and I got out and I was standing by the door and something overwhelmed me. And the next thing I know, I'm a Southern Baptist preacher. You don't forget that. I'm about 65 years old, so I'm kind of real reserved. But something got a hold of me and the next thing I know, I was running around that truck on the side of the road. Out here in the country. He said a truck went by, said, breaker, breaker, you got problems? Breaker, breaker. I can't tell you what's going on or something got in that cabin and got in me, and I don't know what it is, because God said I'm going to pour out my spirit upon all flesh, your sons and your daughters. Your sons and your daughters. Hell don't like it. The predator don't like it. It's just common nature to hide from the predator. But the church, hallelujah, is going to tame and tell the devil, I'm not blending in no more. I'm rising to the occasion. Glory to God.
I can't be hid, I can't be hid, I can't be hid, I can't be hid, Lord.
Oh,
I can't be hid, I can't be hid, I can't be hid, I can't be hid, Lord. I can't be here. I can't be here. I can't be here. I can't be here, Lord. I can't be here. I can't be here. I can't be here. I can't be here, Lord. No, I won't be here. I won't be here, I won't be here, I won't be here, Lord. Cause we're on the move, we're on the move, we're on the move. Yeah, we're on the move, Lord. We're on the move, we're on the move, Lord. We're on the move, cause we're on the move, we're on the move, we're on the move, we're on the move, Lord. Move me, Lord, move me, Lord. Move me, Lord, move me, Lord, yeah. Move me tonight, Jesus. Move me tonight, God. Move me, Lord, move me, Lord, move me, Lord, move me, Lord. Cause we're on the move, we're on the move. We're on the move, we're on the move, Lord. Lord, we know that you're on the move.
You're on the move,
you're on the move, you're on the move, Lord. You're on the move, God, yeah. We know you're on the move. We lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, Lord. Jesus, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, Lord. We lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, Lord. Lord, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, we lift you high, Lord. 'cause you're holy, holy. Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb, yeah.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Oh,
you are holy, holy. Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Oh. Come on, lift your hands. Tell Jesus, are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. 'Cause you are holy. There's none like you, Jesus. Holy. Oh, Lord. Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, oh, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, oh, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
In this place, to where when you walk out those doors, this fire that you have can be spread. I'd ask you to slip out of your seat. There's plenty of room for anybody, young, old. Every one of us needs to move. Can you say amen? Every one of us needs to move. Come to this altar and say, God, that spirit of timidity, take it away from me. I don't want to be timid no more, God, but I want to speak when you tell me to speak. I want to move when you tell me to move. Let God set a fire in your soul that you can't contain it no more, that you can't hold back. Let him do it in you tonight. Let him do it in you tonight. Come on, young and old. You need delivered. Come to this altar. You need set free. Come to this altar. Squeeze in and begin to call out to God.
Down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control, 'cause I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God.
set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more.
Set a fire.
You set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more.
Cause I want more.
I want more. I want more. I want more. I want more. I want more. I want
you. Pour it out.
I want more. I want more.
You provide the fire, and I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit, and I will open up the side.
Fill me up, God. Fill me. Fill me up.
Lift your hands.
God, fill me up, God, fill me up. Oh, fill me up, God, fill me up, God, fill me up, God, fill me up. Just fill me up, fill me up, God, fill me up.
Because I finally found where I belong. Yes, I finally found where I belong in your presence. I finally found where I belong just to be with you. Yeah, I finally found where I belong. Yeah, I finally found where I belong in your presence. I finally found where I belong just to be with you. Yeah, I finally found where I belong. Finally found where I belong in your presence. Finally found where I belong just to be with you. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Kingdom, yours is the power.
Yours is the glory forever. Amen.
Yours is the King. Lift him up. Lift him up. It's his kingdom. For yours. Let heaven, God, we press into you. We press into you, God. Let heaven come. Let heaven come. Let
just wanted to give the youth a word of encouragement. You know, I was 15 years old when the Lord touched me. And there's nothing like serving God. Don't let the old devil lie to you and tell you, paint you a pretty picture and tell you that the world is better. Have fun, you got plenty of time. Listen, God wants to bless you. God wants to give you life more abundantly tonight. God wants to fill you. God wants to use you to go into your families, go to your lost loved ones, and he wants to raise you up in your families and spread the good news. And God will fill you tonight and bless you till you overflow tonight. Give the Lord a hand clap tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Look, it's hard to close a service like this, you know, when the Spirit's moving in a mighty way. Let's give the Lord a hand clap for Leon Bachelor's word tonight. Appreciate it, Brother Leon. You're right on time. Let's stay here for a few moments because we got to take an offering up. We got to take an offering. If we can get a couple brothers in the back there. Just stay right where you're at. Stay in the atmosphere of praise and worship. Who do we got back there? George and Eddie? In the back? Al? We're going to take up an offering. We're coming back tomorrow night. Come on, give the mighty shout to God. Listen, this thing's just, however God moves, however long it goes, we're going to be obedient to the Spirit. We're not going to get in God's way. Listen, this is a mighty move, guys. This ain't just a weekend thing here. Amen. This is everlasting, life-changing experience tonight. Tomorrow night, Jimmy, 7:30. Bring somebody out with you. Come expecting. Come believing. Amen. Come ready. Can you say it? Come ready to worship. We're going to sing some more worship songs, and I mean, we're going to praise God a little bit longer. So don't worry about that. We're going to be here, and we're going to close. But if you have to leave, you can leave. But if you want to stay, you can stay. Benny, pray over that offering and bless that, and then we'll take that and we'll sing a worship song or praise.